एवरीवन, मायसेल्फ स्वाति जयवंत कोकाटे फ्रॉम नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड और लर्न वन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लेसन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, लेसन नंबर 2, इनसाइड आर अर्थ. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव लर्न इन वेरी लेस और वेरी जस्ट वी हैव लर्न इन वेरी फ्यू वर्ड्स अबाउट वॉट इज आउटसाइड द अर्थ. From the lesson's name itself, today's lesson, we are going to see what is the interior of the earth, what is inside the earth. In previous lecture, we have seen, in previous lesson, we have seen that biosphere, atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere, isn't it? So now, in the lesson, this lesson, interesting lesson, we are going to see inside our earth, that is interior of the earth. So any time did you think, children, what is earth? Or many times you have seen or many times you have listened that we live on the earth, okay, we live on the earth. Then whether our earth is like a ball, a tennis ball, whether it is empty inside or whether water is there or whether air is there, what is there inside the earth? Did you think any time or now there may be questions in your mind that then what teacher is there telling what is there in this earth? Now there may be many questions in your mind. So let us go to this lesson and learn what is inside the earth, what is the interior of the earth. We have seen the earth on which we live, that is our homeland where we live. It is a dynamic planet. What is dynamic? What is the meaning of this dynamic? Means it is constantly going or it is constantly undergoing changes inside as well as outside the earth. Then what this dynamic means, it doesn't remain constant, children, means always there are changes. What will be the changes today, it will not be the next year. Constant changes are going on in the interiors of the earth, inside our earth. So as I told you, there may be question in your mind that what is inside the earth? It is like a ball, or what it is inside, water is there, air is there, then what things are there, let us see today. So interior of the earth, with simple examples also we are going to see and make the things clear. So it is inside the earth. Have you seen an onion? Okay, how the layers are there? If you cut it, you will find the layers inside the onion, isn't it? In potatoes, do you find any layers? No. So in onion you find some layers, so one after the another you can find the layers. Same way in this interior of the earth also there are many layers, several concentric layers with one sided to another, means one after the another the layers are there. Then what these layers are of the same size or of the same pattern, like onion is of the same pattern, the size also somewhere is same, but the interior, these layers of the earth are not even, not of same size. We are going to study these layers of earth today. Like now earth, okay, the uppermost layer is called as crust. This uppermost layer of the earth surface is called crust. It is the thinnest of all, means it is about 35 kilometers. Children, you will say that 35 kilometers, it's very big size, but teacher is saying that 35 kilometer means it is the thinnest. But you can see that the earth's radius is 6371 kilometers, okay. Then as per comparatively this, comparing this kilometers, you can say that the outer cover is very thin, so it is only 35 kilometers, and the rest two I am going to teach you, those are of the more size. Then first one we have seen that the outermost cover, okay, it is called as crust, and what is its size? It is of 35 kilometers. And it is the thinnest layer, okay, that outer cover is the thinnest layer of all. on the continental mass and only 5 kilometers on the ocean floor. See children, this ocean floor and continental mass or continental floor, you can see that under this we have seen that what is under the water also somewhere land is there, or only when where we go only do you find water and water and water. No, somewhere land is also there. So some we have to go little downside, fine. So from the continental masses and only 5 kilometers from the ocean floor. So this difference you have to listen and understand, that this even if we say that ocean floors downstairs, that land is there. Oh, fine. Then we can with a simple example we can say that you have seen an egg, children, you have seen an egg. In that the outer cover, white cover, how it is very thin but hard, isn't it? So the outer cover we can say that it is a crust, fine. And then after it what comes, it yellow part comes or what? No, then comes after the that cover white part comes, isn't it? So we can say that white part as mantle, which we are going to study after this. First one we have seen the crust, then it is a thinnest part, and also it covers about 35 kilometers on the continental mass and only 5 kilometers on the ocean floors. Then we are going to come to the white part. An example of egg I am giving you, the outer one that is cover, which is little hard, that we can say it as a crust. Then the white part comes, isn't it, that we can say it as mantle. Okay, the white part we can say it as mantle, and the yellow part after that you find the innermost part is called as core. These are the main three parts which we are going to learn. So we can say that CMC, fine, crust, mantle and core. Crust is the thinnest, then comes the white part, that is mantle, and then comes the yellow part, we can say that it is a core. These main things we are going to learn, children, these three main parts. And again there are sub parts like mantle, core mantle, boundary, outer core, inner core, all these things are there, but which we are going to deal in the next sessions or in the later sections. Now in this topic we are going to learn this main three topics, isn't it? What is the interior of the earth? So first is crust, then comes the mantle, and the innermost is the what we call core. Okay, crust, mantle and core, these three things we have to learn, children. Now we have seen the crust, isn't it? Let us see some of the things. The deepest mine in the world, you know, the deepest mine in the world is South Africa. Means as we dug it, it is about 4 kilometers deep. And search for these oil engineers, they have to dug about 6 kilometers to find the oil inside that area. And also one more point we have to see, to reach to the center of the earth, means to reach where is the center of the earth, this core, as I told you, to reach here, which is not possible at all. Okay, you will have to dig a hole of 6000 km, near about 6000 km you have to dig to reach the center of the earth, and it is very hard to reach there, means it is not at all possible. It is deep on the ocean floor, fine, children. Now I have given the example of interior or just an egg, and we have just found it in a simple way how it is, the earth's surface is interior of the earth. In that just now we saw crust, okay, what is the area, it is the thinnest part. Then the main mineral constituents of continental mass are what things, what is it made of, what it does it consist of, fine. It consists of the minerals, it has the minerals of continental mass. It is silica and alumina, these two words are there which are new for you, but these stones or these stones, these are silica and alumina, which aluminium things nowadays you find, these are made from alumina, this is a metal. So these things, it is made up of silica and alumina. It is thus called as Cl. Okay, it is thus called as Cl because silica's Si and alumina's Al they have taken. Okay, the oceanic crust mainly consists of silica and magnesium. It is therefore called sima. So the oceanic crust, there are two types of crust. As I told you, the land what is there under that water, it is called as oceanic crust. It also consists of, then what these two differs, this land is different here, and here in the oceanic crust it is made up of magnesiums and silica. Here first one is silica and aluminium, you have to remember, that is Cl, and in this oceanic crust how you have to remember, as sima, that is silica and magnesium. Okay, sima, Ma for magnesium. So if you are finding little difficult, children, let us go to an video and see here this interior of the earth.
The earth's interior consists of rocks and metals. It is made up of five main layers. The crust is where we live. Next comes the upper mantle or the asthenosphere. Next is the lower mantle, followed by the outer core, and lastly is the inner core. Earth has a diameter of 12,756 km. Let us now learn about the depth of each layer. Starting from the innermost layer, the inner core extends up to 1300 km. The outer core extends up to 3500 km. Mantle, including both the lower and the upper mantle, extends up to 6400 km. The crust varies from 5 to 50 km in depth.
So children, here we are going to see, we have seen, or we can tell that how this area or how this distance of this core, mantle, inner core, lithosphere or outer core, how, what is the area of these things. So here we have seen that just beneath the crust is the mantle. Okay, after crust what comes beneath, after the crust is the mantle. I told you that white part. Okay, remember that example of an egg. Then comes the mantle, which extends up to a depth of 2900 kilometer. As we have seen in this video, the kilometers or the area, what the things are. This was first we have seen that crust, which is the thinnest and was of only 35 kilometers in the continental mass, and only 5 kilometers on the ocean floor. Also, we have seen in that what were the main minerals, what were found, means on that layer, crust layer, what thing it was made up of. Even though earth is there, then this layer is of this different type, and again mantle is of different things, it constitutes of different things. Then again comes the core, it has again different sands or soils, or we can say different things, metals. Fine, then we have seen that the main constituents of the continental mass are silica and alumina first, and then we have seen, and it was called as Cl. Then the ocean crust we have seen, which consists of silica and magnesium, so it is called as sima. Like this, you have to remember Cl and sima, it is therefore called as sima. Then we came to next point, that is mantle. Fine children, which is just beneath the crust, and what is the area, it extends up to the depth of 2900 kilometers below the crust. So what is its area? It is of depth It extends up to 2900 kilometers below the crust. Then the innermost layer, the innermost layer of this is the core with the radius about 3500 kilometers. So children, we can say, see here that the innermost layer, what is the innermost layer of this core with the radius? What is radius? The half of the circle. It is of 3500 kilometers. And what is this constitutes of? What are the main things in it? It is mainly made up of nickel and iron and is you called as NIF, like nickel ka Ni and iron Fe. Okay, it is called, and Fe is for ferrous, that is similar thing for iron, same word. The central core has very high temperature and pressure. So this central core, it has very high temperature and pressure over here. Again, let us revise. The innermost layer is the core with the radius of about 3500 kilometers. It is mainly made up of nickel and iron and is called NIF, that is nickel and ferrous iron. Then center core, the central core has very high temperature and pressure over here. Again, new things. Do you know in that you, it is given the crust forms only 1% of the volume of the earth. Okay, means we have seen it is very thinnest part and it forms only 1% of the volume of the earth. But and 84% consists of mantle and 15% makes the core. So the radius of the earth is 6371 kilometers. Fine, in this 6371 kilometers, we can find that the crust forms a very little part, that is only 1% of the volume of the earth, and rest 84% consists of mantle and 15% makes the core. So like this, what is the main area or what volume does the other takes? That is more percent is taken by mantle, and after that only 15% makes the core. Fine, like this. Let us see in the another video, children. You will find it very interesting and you will be, it will be easy for you to understand also.
The earth's radius is about 4000 miles or 6400 kilometers. The main layers of its interior are the crust, mantle and core. The thickness of the crust averages about 50 kilometers under the continent, but is only about 5 kilometers under the ocean. The density of the continental crust is 3 grams per cubic centimeter, whereas the density of the oceanic crust is 2.7 grams per cubic centimeter. The mantle is a highly viscous layer present between the crust and the outer core. The mantle is relatively flexible, so it flows instead of fracturing. It extends down to about 2900 kilometers below the surface. The density of the mantle is 3.4 grams per cubic centimeter. Core is divided into two layers, the inner core and the outer core. The inner core is solid and is about 1300 kilometers thick. The outer core is about 2200 kilometers thick and is so hot that the mantle is always in the molten stage. The fluid contains iron, which on moving generate Earth's magnetic field. The density of the inner core is 13 grams per cubic centimeter, whereas the density of the outer core is 5 grams per cubic centimeter.
So children, we have seen here the interior of the earth. Okay, what does it consists? Fine. So let us see again, once again let us revise, because it is very difficult or new words are there and you will find very confusing as we go further. So let us revise once again, as the earth is a dynamic planet, where it is a homeland, our homeland, where we live on the earth. And why it is called a dynamic planet? Because there are always changes, constant changes in the interior as well as exterior of the earth, inside as well as outside the earth. Then what these changes are, we have studied in the interior of the earth. We have seen three types, okay, three parts, types of layers, layers of the earth, that is outer layer, and then inner was the mantle, and the innermost was the middle was the mantle, and the innermost was the core. Is it easy now to understand? Then further, what it consists of and all, you have to, these kilometers, what it was, these things at least you have to read more than 3-4 times, then only you will remember the things. Then let us once again recapitulate. Interior of the earth, what does it consists of? So the radius of the earth is 6371 kilometers. It is made up of several concentric layers with one inside the other, just like an onion, as I told you. So there are three types of layers. First one is called crust. It is the uppermost and thinnest layer over the earth's surface, which is about 35 kilometers on the continental mass and only 5 kilometers on the ocean floor. Also, I had told you what is the difference between continental floor and ocean floor. Even if you are thinking that ocean means only water, whether it has floor, but as you go deep inside that, you will find at a level, you will find somewhere land, isn't it? Only water is not there. Somewhere you go deep and you will stay, or you can stand there. Same way, there land is also there. So continental mass consists of silica and alumina. Fine. What is this continental mass? What does it consist? Means what it is made up of, which soil or which stone? These two are silica and alumina. These two you have to remember as Cl. Okay. Silica and alumina. This mineral constitutes, thus it is called as Cl. Cl, silica and alumina. The oceanic crust mainly consists of, and again come to the oceanic crust, what does it consist of? It consists of silica and magnesium. Here in first we found silica and alumina, and here in oceanic crust you have to see silica and magnesium. It is therefore called as SEMA. Like this, two words, Cl and SEMA, you can remember. The crust forms only 1% or 0.5% of the volume of the earth, as we have discussed. Means this crust is of only 1%. It contributes to only 1% of the total area of the earth. Then we have come to the next thing, next point, that is in the middle, what it is? Mantle. M for middle or M for mantle also, you can remember like this. Core, mantle, then crust, mantle, then core. So next one is the middle, is called mantle. It is just beneath the crust, as I told. After that means crust, then comes the mantle, which extends up to a depth. What is the depth of this? Of 2900 kilometers below the crust. The mantle forms 16% of the volume of the earth. So what is the volume, what is the area of this mantle? It contributes or it forms the 16% of the volume of the earth. And what is its depth? Its depth is 2900 kilometers below the crust. means after crust you can see this area is covered about 2900 kilometers, and in percentage we can see it contributes to 16% of the volume of the earth. Then first one crust you understood, then we have seen mantle and what it is made up of also we have seen, then come to the core. Okay, the third point which we are going to see in detail is core. So the innermost layer, the middle, or what is the center, the innermost layer of the core with a radius about 3500 kilometers. So it is the largest one. The innermost layer is the core with a radius of about 3500 kilometers. Then what is this made up of? Okay, what is there in core? Why we have differentiated these all things on this basis only, that these things we in crust we what we find, that we have seen CL and SEMA. Okay, in mantle why these things are different. Now core, what is the difference? On this basis only we have differentiated all these things in the interior of the earth. So the innermost layer of the core with the radius, it is, its radius is about near about 3500 kilometers. And what it is made up of? It is made up of nickel and iron, and it is called NIF because Fe is for ferrous, same thing, that is iron. So nickel and ferrous. The central core has very high temperature, so here the temperature here is very high and the pressure also here is too much. It forms 83% of the volume of the earth. So maximum volume of the earth you can find here in core, that is 83%, and here mantle we have seen 16%, and crust how, what was the percent? 1, 16, and 83, like this you can remember. Fine, for practice children you can draw this interior of the earth's diagram, as well as continental crust and ocean crust. Means oceanic crust means you will find the difference, what is, how this land is there below this ocean also, and this continental crust. On page number, lesson number 2, page number 7, you have to draw this diagram for the practice. Also read, do you know what we have read in this lesson and studied? Do you know on these two pages you go through? Fine. In next chapter or next subtopics we are going to learn rocks and minerals. Okay, different rocks and minerals. What are rocks? What are minerals which we find in the interior of the earth? Then we are going to see different types of rocks. Then in that different types of rocks, we are going to see which are the major types of rocks. Igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks. Yeah, if you find these new words, means you will find it little difficult, but as we study what are these things, like now, till now you are not knowing crust, mantle, core, but now you found it very easy to understand after recapitulating it. Then definitely you will also learn in the next topic, that is types of rocks subtopic, in that we are going to see these different types of rocks. Okay children, for this just read the lesson till where we have finished and learn also the difficult words, so that you will remember also. Okay, thank you.